Welcome to Car Questions. What we have here is a Mercedes-Benz C300 2011. This customer is complaining that in the morning, when the car is cold, and only then, when they first start it up, that the car is making a hell of a screeching sound. So typically that can be, you know, anything like a power steering belt or pulley or something like that. On the Mercedes, this problem, this particular part seems to be the problem. It's a secondary air pump. It's an emission device, which comes on first thing to evacuate some fumes and get some air into the exhaust system right away. So this thing is suspect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug it here. It's a 12-volt motor, and I'm going to power it directly. Car's cold, and the only thing I'm going to be powering up is this. Now, if this thing squeals like there's no tomorrow, then that's proof positive this is the problem. To replace it, it's about $700 Canadian just for the part. Just gonna get this hose out of the way. This tube just pulls off. Here is the electrical connection. I'm just gonna use my cotter pin puller to squeeze the connection. And off she comes. It's marked 1 and 2. Which one's positive and negative? Have to have a closer look at that. Mercedes has a very convenient ground lug right there. Get a good grip on that. And put the other one there for the time being. And slide this out of the way. And attach this to the positive. Just gonna check to see if that's positive or negative. There we go. There's a 1 and a 2 on it. Oh, there it is, negative. And I can see a positive on that bottom one. Yeah, so top pin looks like it's negative. Anyway, let's give it a go. See if this thing squeals. Okay. The negative one. Positive one. Careful not to touch anything. Okay. There we go. Scared myself. That's pretty noisy. Is that the noise she's talking about? I don't know. Well, let's start the car up and see what it does. See if it makes a heck of a noise like that. That's what she's talking about. Sounds pretty noisy. Let's give her a go. That's pretty noisy. Oh, there we go. Well, I don't know what a good one's supposed to sound like, but that one sounds really noisy. So that is the issue. It's not a pulley, it's not the power steering, it's that. It's a secondary air pump. So what I'm going to do is replace it. Before I do that, and actually take it apart, see if I can get it to shut up, maybe put a little grease in it, something. Try to save it, it's an expensive part. I wanna know why it failed. Step one in the process of replacing this, just pull off this rubber hose. No clamps on it, put it in a safe place out of the way, Second step, I'm going to disconnect it electrically. Make sure the key's out. Make sure the key's nowhere near the car, as a matter of fact. You don't want to code. You don't want to have to reset anything. I'm using a cotter pin puller to get under that clip and help push on one of the little release pins. And with my other finger, I'm going like that and jiggle it. And off she comes. So disconnect the power to it. Just put that out of the way a little bit. Anywhere is good. It doesn't look like it's going to go very far. Next, I'm using a quarter midget drive ratchet, and that's a T30 that I'm using. Seems to fit well. First bolt, out it comes. Not too hard, that's good. I like that. Sometimes it gives you trouble. Put some WD-40 on it first. If it's an older model, a little rusted up more than this one. Okay, I'm gonna take that off, put it right up here, out of the way. Next, take your Torx T30, and there's a bracket right here, you can see, and there's a Torx T30 bolt right there, and use that to take off this bolt. Now the second bolt I just took out is a T30 Torx, but it's shorter than the last one. So keep them separated. You never want to interchange the two. They'll screw right in. The thread diameter is the same and the threads are the same, but you always want to keep them separated. So make a diagram, or just don't forget, they have to go back in exactly the same spot they came out of. Okay, the next bolt you want to get to. Okay, the next bolt you want to get to is right there. It's on the end of my Torx T30, and the bolt we just took out, it's just above it. So this one's just below it. Be careful, take that one out. And there's a third bolt right in this location. So right here, there's one, a lower one, two, and a third one, and I'm taking that out. And then over here, I'm going to take out a fourth bolt. It's right here behind some plastic stuff that holds the bracket on. Careful not to force anything. And keep all the bolts separate. They're different lengths. Remember where they go. The last bolt I did was over here, and it loosens this bracket. I didn't take the bolt out. For now, I'm just going to loosen it. So there's five bolts all together. A long one goes here, two short ones, then a longer one, all right here besides this near the sidler pulley, and then the fifth one over here, and they're all Torx T30. Okay, so the next thing, looks like it's loose. I'm just gonna use a screwdriver or my handy cotter pin puller and try to get the rubber hoses off of here. Should come off one way or the other. Still two hoses. Here's one here, down there. Push on it a bit. Hopefully it comes off. There we go. That's off of there. And this one, pop it off of here, I guess. There we go. And it comes out. So that's all there is to it now. To completely disassemble it, I take this bracket off, and it looks like that's not going to be T30. Where is it? Oh, that looks like T30. That'll do. Before I take anything apart that's cylindrical in nature like this, it's always a good practice to put some kind of an alignment mark on the two parts you're separating, just so when you go to put them back together again, if they're round, there's a chance you could put them in a different location, and I don't want to do that. So, I've made enough mistakes in my life. Just a few little alignment marks with a Sharpie can save you a lot of headaches later. Believe me, I know. So, anyway, taking the Torx T30 and loosen up the nuts. Or the bolts, I should say. 2, same length. Three, and off that comes. Just gonna put the bolts back in there for safekeeping. So I've got a motor, and it still has that on it. So now I'm just gonna take my small screwdriver, see if I can pop these off. There we go, standard tip screwdriver. They come off relatively easy from behind here. Get in there. Might keep this motor if I can get it. Might not. It's got one, two, three, four, five of these metal clips. Okay, this is a Bosch as well. What's the number on it? People always ask me numbers. There's all kinds of numbers on it. 0580-000-026-816. Made in Germany. Anyway, if you're gonna replace this, you know, my feeling is with parts that let you down and break prematurely, as this car has, it only has about 140K on it, Canadian, so that's like 70,000 miles, 75,000 miles American. If a part lets you down and there's another manufacturer of that part, use them, because the first company let you down, why would you buy from them again? But in some cases you have to, if there's no choice. Okay, it looks like that comes off pretty easy. What do we got here? Got a cover. I don't see any scratching or anything. Clean looking. Some kind of fancy fan. Some other kind of cover that goes underneath it. Looks like I gotta take this nut off. And it looks like a sealed unit, so chances of getting this fixed, who knows. Got a 3/8 ratchet with a 13 millimeter socket. Remember, this thing is foreign, so it's metric. And hopefully, give it a good yank and the nut comes off. That's great. Oh, there we go. Wow, how many pieces is this thing? Okay, so there's that. There's this. I don't see any rub marks or any damage in there. Cool little aluminum fan blade. How does this work? Oh. Take that off. And I guess this comes off too. And another fan. This bent. Looks straight. Okay, so keeping the parts in order. That went under it like that, with that piece in between. Okay. What's next? Oh yeah. We got some small Torx. Got a washer right there. Looks like it can go on either way. Put that underneath that long sleeve. I wonder if the bearing's shot. There's the bearing right there. Or is it shut on the inside? Anyway, looks like any little Torx.
Let me just that.
Stick that in the end. My quarter midget driver ratchet, same one I used over there. And undo these two. These are going right into plastic, I guess. Does that get me? Let's see how that gets me. Anything really? The back of this thing seems to be all in piece. Well, looks like it's time to go into the vise. I'm going to put it in the vise and I'm going to pull on it. So should put the nut on the end of that. Hopefully that one gets out. Let this come out. There we go. There we go. All right. What do we have there? Well, got quite a bit of dust on there. Lots of dust. You can get to the bearings on either end of it. Maybe you can just shoot some stuff in there and quieten it up. Quite a bit of dust there. The bearings seem okay as far as movement, but obviously this thing was noisy and the fan wasn't rubbing on anything, so it's got to be the bearings. There's only so much to it. If the fan's not rubbing on the inside because of some foreign object, then it has to be here, and I see a lot of carbon dust or some kind of dust. So I'm going to blow this thing out and maybe take my small syringe and inject a little bit of grease into it. See what happens. A lot of dust in this thing, boy. Well, what I figured on doing was taking a small scratch awl and putting a hole in it first. That seems to be a better idea. And then I can get my grease in there. And just do the, push a little bit in there. Come on, get in. I don't know if I'm getting it in or getting it all over the place. And give a little bit of a turn. This is the bad bearing or not. I want that grease back on. Just get it like that. Get back on there. Back in. Go to the other side. Put a hole there somewhere. There it is. I think this one's working much better. Give it a little turn. Get that in there. Work it in. Turn it. Do this a number of times. Just make sure you're trying to get grease in there. Next the hole. And once you've done it a number of times, put your ball back together. We'll see what it sounds like. So I'm going to test it before I put it back in. And let's see what it sounds like now. It definitely sounds a lot better. Doesn't sound like a jet anymore. So, all you have to do now is take this air pump and do the reverse procedure to put it back in, and everything should be fine. Remember, don't put the key anywhere near the car or turn the ignition until this thing is fully connected and is in the car and the job's finished. When you start it up, you shouldn't get any error messages, and this thing should be quiet. Thanks for watching Car Questions, and please subscribe.